My people, before we go there, I'm gonna see the receipt where they produce for us. As this Ewu Gambia, aka Ojegile Netherlands, saying one they turn people heads. My people, I'm gonna see receipt where this in best side produce.
Hey guys, Blessing here. So I quickly wanted to address this thing that I just saw online now, and I find it quite embarrassing, but I want us to really take our time. If you're watching this video, just really take your time, slow down and listen to every single thing that I'm going to be saying in this video, because I am going to be analyzing these bank statements. So if you guys remember, in my last video, I mentioned that Monica announced to her fans that she got some money back from the Dutch government. If you haven't watched that video, you go right to the description box down below. I have it linked there. And there is also a pop-up at the top of the screen. You can click on that and go watch that video before you come back to continue to watch this one, so that you get the full context of the story. So after Monica made that announcement video, some people came out and said that the bank statement that Monica showed and all of the screenshots that she posted on her social media are all fake, that they have been doctored, they have been photoshopped, and she is busted. And that is one thing that I specifically want to clarify today, because a lot of people have now been misled and misinformed.
This was the first receipt she produced saying they paid that money. I told her they see the receipt. Mona see we had 25 of January day. Now they see 2021. You know, they the after January, nothing dead there. My people now see this was the receipt she produced that she was paid money. When they come tell and say they lie, my people, she can't go bring this receipt come. Mona tell me how 2021 can't they appear for the paper for January front. Mona they see another lie, another fake ass. Look at now, you don't forge receipt, can't give us. We not take receipt. This receipt is a lie, busted.
So what you see here are two pictures, actually two screenshots that were taken from a mobile banking application. And this is the ground upon which Lolo is saying that this bank statement is fake.
Look at the receipt she produced that they pay her money. Is there 2021 in front of it? No. When they tell her she's lying, she went and bring us this one. Hell, oh, je gile one or sheshe ge. You can't go bring us this receipt. My people, how 2021 tell this year? The receipt when na mama bring, it is busted. Do not hear me. It is busted. That receipt is fake. It's not acceptable. I told you people that they are amateur 419 people. You not believe me, Abby. The name was written small here. I zoom it. The name was written small on this part, while the name is now written bigger here in a different form. My people, more now, see the writing of the name of the people who pay out the money is small here. Now they see.
What I'm about to explain to you guys and demonstrate, because I do not like to make my videos without proof. What I'm going to show you guys right here is a screenshot that I got from the internet, from Google to be precise. And I just keyed in these words that you see here, and it means ING bank statement overview, because Monica uses ING, like I already said. So the picture you see here on the left is the first picture that Monica posted to prove that the Dutch government indeed sent her a certain amount of money. Now, this picture that you're seeing here, the one on the left is a summarized view of her bank statement. The screenshot on the right, however, is a detailed view. So let me explain this differently. Once you log into your mobile banking app on your phone, the first thing you're going to see is a list of all the transactions that you have made. And that list doesn't show all the complete information of each transaction. It just shows you a summary. So if you want to get all the full details, the amount, the reason the money was sent, the payment reference, and so many other information, you would have to click on one of the transactions that you want to focus on. And then when you click on that transaction, it's going to bring you to the view on the right, if that makes sense. And I totally understand that those people who do not use mobile banking apps might not entirely understand how this works or what I'm talking about. Now, let us go to the ING bank picture that I downloaded from Google. Now, what you see here in this picture is exactly the same screenshot that Monica had on the left. It's an overview of all of your transactions. It doesn't contain the year. And you guys do not have to take my word for it. Just go over to Google, guys. Don't let yourself be misinformed. Always check your sources and do the research for yourself. We all have smartphones. Let us use our phones smartly. Go over to Google and check this thing out yourself. You can see here that on this picture that I got from the internet, this summarized view does not contain the year. It only tells you the date and the month. But when you click on any of these transactions, say for example you click on Backer Bat or you click on Fishhandel T von der Geest, you are going to see a more detailed view, and in that view you are then going to see the year in which the transaction was made. I hope that still makes sense to you guys. It's right there on Google. This is how this thing works. Anyone who uses a mobile banking app should know that this is how it works. But if there is someone out there who doesn't use such an application, then just please listen to this video over again. And I've really tried my best to really explain this thing as simply as possible. And if you still don't understand this explanation, then I'm really sorry I cannot help you further. Another important thing that I feel like I should mention is that we all have to be guided and very careful about the things that we say online. When we accuse people, we should always do our research before we come up there to really say things that are false about anybody. Whether we hate them, whether they are enemies, we should just be very careful, because what just happened right here is defamation of character. By falsely accusing someone of being deceptive and not telling the truth, that is actually punishable by law. So we all need to be very, very careful, because this is social media and we might just, you know, take it with a pinch of salt and say, oh, nothing is going to happen, I just say what I want to do to get back at my enemy. But once someone decides to take legal actions against anyone, it can really have severe consequences. So once again, let us all be really careful and guided. Moving on to another point that Lolo made, that Monica's fans have been bullying her fans into silence.
They don't know why they vest now. These people will go to my followers, they will go to my fans and go and be bullying them inbox, threatening them inbox. That is why fear don't allow anybody to comment. They follow all my fans, all my followers. If you comment here, now the next thing you will see, they start threatening you inbox. If they do it to any of you again, I will make sure Ejegile will live to regret it.
This is my standpoint on this matter. If you're guilty of this, you're Monica's fan, and you're guilty of this, you're bullying people that love Lolo, you really need to stop it. I have personally not seen any proof of it. I have not seen any screenshot, any picture of anybody sending messages to bully anyone, but I have seen comments during Lolo's live stream where multiple people came out to say that yes, they were indeed bullied by certain people. I cannot authoritatively confirm the authenticity behind this story, but if you are guilty of it, you know yourself, and you know that you have been sending private messages to people to bully them to silence, you really need to stop it, because it is totally wrong. Cyberbullying is a cyber crime, and there are grave consequences to it. So you guys really need to take a step back and stop it with immediate effect.
All my fans were running away from me. Nobody was commenting on my post anymore. Even if I put picture, nobody liked, nobody nothing. These bastards! They follow all my...
Another person that came out to say that she was also bullied is Lola's goddaughter. But sometimes, you know, certain people do not really have to complain about certain things. But I know that Bianca has also bullied Monica in several YouTube videos that she personally did. So when you're bullying people, you shouldn't really be complaining too much about people bullying you. And it is totally, totally wrong, of course, for anybody to come into your inbox to start to attack you on behalf of Monica.
My goddaughter cry. Say, see what they do me. I say, no worry. Just ignore, it goes to finish, They photoshopped my goddaughter, did everything to her, that one I'll be begging her, it's okay, don't worry now, darling, don't worry now. It's okay, my love, don't worry. They will soon leave us alone, they will soon forget, don't worry, don't.
And Lolo also said that your child was dragged into it. That is the lowest thing you can do to anybody. Why bring innocent children into this thing? I have seen it so rampant on social media. When you have a problem with an adult like you, you bring their kids into it. That only shows weakness, because children are innocent and untouchable. Do not go there. That is a no-go area. Even if they do it to you, the best response is not to retaliate with the same reaction. So you guys really need to start to behave yourselves. You are all adults and you all are behaving like kids that really need to be flogged one after the other. And my definition of stupidity is inheriting another person's enemy. Do not do it, because they do not have a personal problem with you. They have a problem with who they have a problem with. If Lolo and Monica are involved in a saga, if they hate each other, if they are fighting with each other, it is not your place to inherit the other person's enemy, because that would totally be a foolish thing to do. And you don't also know where you're going to meet that person in future. It might not be Lolo directly, it might not be Monica directly, but it might be someone that is closest to Lolo or to Monica. So we all have to be really careful with the actions that we perform today, because they can have an immense impact in the way that our lives turn out in future.
I also deal with you, eh? I swear down. You will not believe your eyes. Me? Shabi, don't show me officially say you dey work. If I not go call them, may they go reference when you first chief or other people ask. You will not say my name no be this Lolo.
And one other thing I find funny, I actually shouldn't be laughing, but I find this one laughable, is where Lolo said that she is going to deal with Monica every single time Monica's fans send messages to her fans.
If they threaten any of you, bring them to me. I will use that yo-yo wa. I'll make sure she reach Nigeria. If they threaten any of you commenting here, I promise you guys, I will deport a yo-yo wa to Nigeria. He says it's an empty threat. I make sure you pack your bag overnight and run away from Netherlands. I will make sure you get to Nigeria. If any of our followers threaten you people again in bus, except you people don't tell me, bring it to me and see what I will do to a yo-yo wa on this social media.
And I'm like, why do you have to hold Monica responsible for what her fans are doing? And this is not to take sides, but I haven't really seen a video in which Monica instigated people to call you in a certain way or to address you in a certain way.
Followers, they are the ones she sent to attack all my fans. I did a video in my fan base alone. All the people who were there feeling relaxed to comment after a long while. These people pursued them in bus. They pursued them in bus and start threatening their lives. Start threatening them, telling them they have gotten their picture. If they comment on Lolo's things again, they are going to do them like this. Those people run away. For how many weeks now I've not seen one say, what's going on? Every day by day, people no longer comment on Lolo post again because these bastards, they are all following my people everywhere. I know get fake account time, but you see, you will be their leader. If you know come months, can't tell them, say, may they stay away from me, and you still continue that your nonsense. Why breaking on me? Where me ya will escape go to Niyaya? People don't comment anymore on Lolo's page. Just because she have all those in best side who put emojis on her post. She chased away on my own.
And holding Monica responsible for what all of her fans are doing on social media is a little laughable, like I said already. Of course, Monica can exercise a bit of influence on them and tell them, look, you guys really need to stop this. I do not condone it. I don't endorse it. It is not my style. And I don't want any of you sending messages on my behalf. And in such a situation, I would also expect you to do exactly the same thing. To also address your fans and tell them that we are putting an end to this war. This social media war should come to an end. But in case both of you have decided not to put this war behind you, but rest assured that there are bloggers out there who are very much ready to help you guys share it further. It has to come from the both of you. It is not a one-way street. So if you guys found this video insightful, do go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and I will continue to update you guys as the story unfolds. Also subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell if you'd like to receive notifications whenever I upload a new video. Share this video with someone you think might like to watch it, and I will catch you on my next one.